Oh, welcome to no delivery. We're gonna do it a little bit different because I was going to be doing a continuation of doing the major dungeon that we have to get the last ending, but I saw and was if you go to the developer's Steam page or not Steam page, the let me just fucking show the main page here. I found. Or, no, I went to his Tumblr. See, you go into his Tumblr page. It says, the pizzeria still has some strange secrets to uncover. Before yesterday, this post was 6 days ago, before October, before yesterday, only 32 people had reached the end of the scavenger hunt in the entire month of October and joined the hunt. It says, scavenger hunt in ARG. So it's an augmented reality game on their main website. So it made me poking around. I found a bunch of interesting shit. And it led me to downloading a file called We Deliver. I'm not really good with puzzles, so we're going to be trying it anyways. No, not this one. So the only thing that is suspicious, and I'll have it so I test out, is this. The We Deliver win, because it made me download a full-length 600 megabyte game for... something else, because the game's called No Delivery, but this file is called We Deliver, and it's slightly bigger than No Deliver's game size, or slightly bigger than No Delivery size, so I'm kind of curious what, it's a game in a game, or it's a game hidden within a website, but not, I haven't seen anyone play We Deliver, so I'm kind of fucking curious what the fuck this is, and what the fuck the password is. But if you move your mouse over here, it says 95, 95, 2, 64, and -861. So I'm not sure if I have to do math, like say this is numbers and you subtract it by this number, or if I just type it in simply. Not sure. It's just gifts of pizza. And it just keeps going down weirdly enough. Like it's deliberately, like the copyright thing is here. It's kind of fucking weird. But I don't know what the password is going to be, so I don't. It's just going to be trial and error because I'm not really good with fucking riddles and shit. But let's try the password of, you know, just top to bottom. 9, 5. Oh, okay, well, no, don't do that. 9, 5, 2, 64, and -861. Whoops, not back to the game, no. And -861. I just want to make sure I'm not getting this fucking wrong. 861. Okay. Now copy paste that. Damn it. See, I got it wrong already. Now I'm going to pop up a calculator. Alright, let's put it in then. Would that be the password? Yeah, it's. Okay, so let's try this number then. Okay, well, that wouldn't be right because of the fucking comma. 900. Damn it. Okay, math is not right. Otherwise, the only other hints you get on this site, home leads to this. And it has. It's gonna have a bunch of information, honestly. Like this. Well, this image has nothing. This says rearrange the 3, channel 27, and 53. So I'm not sure what it means by rearrange the 3. Oh, it says exclusively children ages 13 and below. I'm kind of confused by that. I'm not sure what it wants me to rearrange per se. It could be maybe 27 and 53, but instead you rearrange the 53, so it's 23, maybe, is what it means. Otherwise, if you go to want a job, it does say all employees under Stizzoni, pizza, exhibit, and practice these 3 qualities. I'm not sure if this then is the hint. I've rearranged these 3? But does that mean like the password is literally typing professionalism, competence, and fun, or PCF? If it is in an acronym format? There's so many questions, and since I overthink, it complicates the scenario of thinking what the password is. But first thing we're gonna do for this ARG, is in the home, the channels. Channel 27, we're gonna be checking that out. 27. Will it give us interesting information? Or the password, perhaps? Watch TV. Wait, what? splash. It was the last hour of the day, and they were sent to scrape off the remaining grime in the restroom. Splash. They didn't want to start with the toilets, not yet. Splash. They ignored it this time. It wasn't uncommon to hear such things. Splash. Now was getting just slightly annoying. There was no way of escaping it all. Okay, well, let's just write this down. All. I have no desk space somehow. All. And wait, no capitals. No, no. I wrote capital A. And all. Splash. They readied the mop and started toward the stall. They never got to clock out. Okay. And what was the other one? 53? The clown! At the back. Wait. This channel is blank news. If you're watching this broadcast, request that you change the channel or turn off the television. What? Do what you can to forget what you just witnessed. It is imperative that you forget the image on the screen at this moment. No. Give me a password thing. Give me some yellow words. There we go. To prevent further casualties, local stations and authorities were notified to the threat this open channel poses. Open it is. Oh, pun. All evidence and memory of what's on the screen must be wiped. This message will repeat. This message will repeat. This message will repeat. Am I gonna get shot in the back of the head, Hillary Clinton style again? Okay. Open all. Open all. Is just the password open all? Open all. All open? Because if it says rearrange the three, then I think the password will be within the channels. But I have to find another channel or something. Because I don't... The three. Either that or I could try to complete the sentence all open. It says rearrange the three. I'm going to presume when they say rearrange... Or wait, what was it? Oh yeah, the... Yeah, rearrange the three. I'm presuming they'll mean rearrange the three words until it makes a sentence. So it says all open something. You could presume open all day, open all night. I'll try it. Open... All day. I'll try a bunch of things. Oh, open all night. My guess was right. Oh fuck, that's hilarious. I just was thinking, what wording with restaurants come hand in hand? We're open all night. We're open all day. We're open all night. It was one word. That's hilarious. Fuck me. Okay, but I'm still curious what the channel would be, because if there's going to be a sort of a story or something interesting, then maybe it's channel 64. Let's go with 64, because maybe these are commercials of 2, 5, so we'll try this one, 64. Watch TV, let's see if it's right. Tune in, 64. Because otherwise it's just testing every channel repeatedly, but that would be monotonous. We got the file. Oh man, I don't know. I don't want to get into it until I beat the game. Should I even get into it until after I get all the endings? I really want to leave it as like a secret thing, but now that I've recorded this. Because I haven't officially beat the game. Maybe what I'll do is I was going to have it, so when I began this recording, I was going to be like, yeah, let's do the ARG, let's beat it. Okay, well, I brute forced it, apparently, because the phrase or the password was open all night. I'll leave this until after, so you won't be seeing this in between, because this would have been, like, part 10. I don't want it to be part 10. I want to release this episode when I'm actually done the game. But I'm going to start the We Deliver, and... You'll see it later. So I'm just talking to myself at this rate, but fuck it. Anyways. Let's just continue playing it. I'm going now to Wii Deliver and see what the fuck it is, because I don't know how many people have played this. It's interesting. I wanna fucking know. Alright, so I launched Wii Deliver and we're gonna curiously get right back into it. Or, I mean, we're just gonna play. That's the bitch! Who the fuck is this? The one that fucking Hillary Clinton me in the back of the head. That fuck. Wait, what? I can just leave? Wait. And so the ensuing horrors ceased to be. So it was all thanks to this bitch? What? So that, there we go, there's an ending. There is an ending. Interesting. I mean, I guess I could include that as an ending. Like, is this my first day on the job, or... We just left, and he's like, well, she didn't start anything up, so there's no horrors. Ah. Just a plain animatronic. Nothing in the garbage. Is this before no delivery? No? Can't even go to the phone. I'm gonna presume this is before it started up or something. Oh, we just skimmed everything and went to the basement from here? Okay. The furnace. The fat cat! What's the fat... What? Did she just brutally murder the cat? What? Is this the past, present, or future? And why did she kill the cat? I don't have an inventory. I just killed the fucking fat cat. But didn't I kill the cat with a heart attack and no delivery? What? Am I gonna give this soul to this thing? No wonder it makes that noise. Wait, the broken ones always make the cat noise if it's having a heart attack. And so the shift begins. This fucking bitch. That's it? Really? It's a precursor? This bitch is like, hey, I'm just gonna go to work. Is she the manager? The fuck? And she just kills the cat and is able to acquire souls, FNAF style. And she put the cat in the pizzeria mascot girl. And that's why every time you get healed by it, you hear, like, I guess it's cat noises. Because all the time, like, when you get healed, when you're in a wrong turn, and you get healed by a broken down one, you only hear, like, the oog, erg. And when we killed the fat cat with an XX large cheesy thing, it always makes the same noise. We can't hear it being, you know, cat noise, or cat gurgle, or cat heart attack. It's always the erg or ug, and I'm going to believe it's maybe she transport, like, all these mascots, it's just the cat's soul in all of them. I'm not sure how all of them, I'm guessing just one mascot and it keeps moving around, but it's the cat's soul that's making it move. The fuck? Well, this bitch is to blame for everything, especially for shooting me in the back of the head, trying to answer the call. But that's all there is to the game, apparently, is... What if I kill the cat and leave the store, though? I'm gonna see if it does anything else. And then, that's just it. Just we deliver augmented reality. The cat's just sleeping there. I'm so confused, though. Why the cat? Why is it fat? Why did she kill it? Can I just leave with a soul? Like, hey, that's cool. I'm just gonna kill that cat and go the fuck on home. And so the forbidden knowledge spread, and saw to the end of mankind. Huh, it was a different ending. The information spread, so it's like, theory. So she kills the cat and puts it in the soul, and from that path, if she kills the cat and transports the soul, she figures it out, and then continues doing so within the confines of the pizzeria. But if she killed the cat and was like, hey, I can take souls, if she had left the pizzeria, then she would have basically, I don't know, begin to show the world that she can do that and sort of, I don't know, try to be a fucking, like, necromancer? I don't fucking know, man. Because it was a different ending just based on this killing the cat, taking the soul, but not putting it in animatronic, putting that knowledge to use outside of the pizzeria. But in No Delivery, I think that is the... Let's say it's like timeline A and timeline B sort of stuff. This is the precursor to No Delivery. In pathway or in timeline one, which is the main timeline, she kills the cat, puts an animatronic, and goes, we gotta keep doing this. And in timeline B, she kills the cat and goes, this is nice. I'm gonna go home and ponder what I can do with this newfound ability that I don't know why I have. And that's timeline B, which is not part of No Delivery. So maybe we will get a future game. We'll be on timeline B. So you have to think of it like Steins Gate sort of, you know, timeline shit. Interesting. But that's all there is to the game, to my knowledge. Because you can't enter any other rooms. You kill the cat and you decide to leave, or you decide to put an animatronic. And that's just sort of a build-up to the events of No Delivery. Interesting. I hope you enjoyed this augmented reality game. Interesting. Very interesting. I'm kind of curious what channel would be required to get the last password of night, but oh well, I brute forced it. I'm glad it wasn't a password that was just, you know, a bunch of fucking numbers, because then I probably would have gotten lost, and, you know, I suck with riddles. Sergals are not big brain creatures. Sergals are meant to be, you know, the headstrong, and, you know, just if they don't like you enough, they'll probably headbutt you rather than solve your fucking stupid ass riddles. It's like you tell a Sergal a riddle, you're like, aha, riddle me this, and the Sergal's just like, they'll just kill you, just fuck off, you make my brain hurt, please. I don't like thinking too much, even as much as I overthink everything. But hey, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave a like, comment, hit that subscribe button, become a subscriber. Hit that bell notification down below for updates on my videos. Thank you for watching, and until the next time.